and a glimpse inside the locker room, players' final few moments to prepare for the game, and the task ahead. From the plains of Oklahoma, welcome high above downtown Oklahoma City. It's Friday night, and live on 2K Sports, we're going to bring you the NBA in all its excitement. Kevin Harlan here with Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg, and we'll have David Aldridge filling us in from the sideline. And now a chance to take a look at some numbers for Beast.
In the last five games, you can see the trend upwards for effective field goal percentage, and it shows you how confident he's playing right now.
And checking out Minnesota's opening lineup, they've got Karl Anthony Towns. Russell is out there with Malik Beasley. And it's Hernan Gomez in at the four spot. And for the Thunder, Gallinari and Adams, the combo out front. Gilgeous Alexander out there with Chris Paul. And it's Dort in at the three spot. Clark, when you have two teams that are this athletic, what type of game you think you're going to see?
Well, you know what? Sometimes it can lead to guys trying to do too much. But when it's at its best with this kind of athleticism on display, I think you're going to see a high-octane, fun game.
Now, here's Gilgeous Alexander. Dishes to Gallinari. Over in the corner, Paul. Five to shoot. Jacks up a three. Rebound, Minnesota. Beasley outside. And Towns throws it down.
Oh, I love how Towns plays with a chip on his shoulder. He brings it every night with force.
Paul dishes to Adams. To the paint. That's good from Gallinari on the assist by Adams.
Yeah, that's a good way to start the game. Nice inside bucket right there.
And it's Russell with the ball. He'll bring it up for the Minnesota Timberwolves. Pass to Okogie. And now, just over a minute played here in the first. He dishes it to Towns. The Timberwolves need to get a shot off here. Here's Russell. The rebound by Steven Adams. And the Thunder with possession. This game coming after a loss against the Jazz. Count that one.
Defense left him just a little window to get through, and he just ducked in for the layup. Terrific job.
And we've got an update here, so let's check in with David Aldridge reporting from the sideline.
Kevin, earlier I spoke with Ryan Saunders. Going over the matchups, it's clear how much he respects Chris Paul's game. Arguably the best point guard of his era, and still getting it done. Kevin, they'll need to try and figure out a way to rein him in tonight.
Okay, David, much appreciated. Now, here's Gilgeous Alexander. With an average of around 19.5 points a game, his scoring has been a constant for them. Over Russell, again, the Thunder score.
You know, they'll take the points, but I'm sure Coach would prefer a higher percentage look next time.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
Here's Russell. He's coming off a 28-point game against Houston.
And equally spent as much energy on his D. I mean, four steals kind of tell the story.
Now, here is Russell. The shot's good.
Well, I tell you, Russell looking very comfortable taking on aggressive defense and getting the job done. That's good focus on his part.
Ball against Russell. Fires from the wing. Paul's shot is off.
Very dangerous to leave a guy like that open. Lucky break there for the D.
High arcing shot, and that one's good. Russell's got his second bucket of the game to go. And so it's Paul with it, bringing it up for Oklahoma City. Adams taking his time here. There's the pass to Paul. Paul can't get that one to fall.
Well, they'll be happy with that look, even though it didn't fall.
You know what? That's a confidence shaker for him, though. I mean, that's a shot he expects to make every time.
Here's Okogie. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. Offensive rebound. And it's Towns missing.
Boy, patrolling the paint well, protecting the rim. That's exactly the kind of defensive effort you need against him.
Towns against Paul. Passes it to Gilgeous Alexander. Now Adams. Good, and Paul gets the assist.
They know he's looking for him, so it's easy to see why Paul's teammates love it.
The Timberwolves have gotten 3 of 8 shots to fall for them here in the first quarter. Russell passes to Towns. Beasley outside. Pass to Russell. Lets it go from deep, and Adams sends it back. Teardrop shot, and it's Gallinari laying it in.
Oh, such a feel shot there, the floater.
Timberwolves trail by 4. Pass to Towns. Back to Russell. They get it back. And that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
Textbook up fake there. Towns does a great job imitating his usual shot motion. Earns himself a trip to the line.
And a look at how the offensive approach has been going here so far for the Thunder.
And so far, these guys have done a fantastic job finding the open man and getting some easy baskets.
Something else they've been able to do so far tonight is earn those tough points in the paint.
First free throw is good. Well, with the playoffs coming up quickly, Clark, strength of schedule can play a big role as it determines where a team is going to be seated come playoff time.
No, I agree with you in terms of even just making the playoffs sometimes, Kevin,
yes,
based on where teams are and who they're playing. I mean, those matchups against potential playoff teams that are still fighting for seeding, they can sharpen you up and get you ready. Actually, those games can be playoffs before the playoffs in many ways.
And I always admire the coaches, Clark, that walk their players through the different scenarios because they should be aware.
Yeah, I agree with you wholeheartedly. You want everything out in front of you. As long as your team is able to handle it, and most of these teams can, I think that's a good point.
Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot 2 free throws.
Yeah, way to play in attack mode and get to the line.
And, you know, the defense gets their money's worth on that foul, stopping the layup and not giving up the and one.
And the first one drops.
And the young Timberwolves head coach, Ryan Saunders, son of former Minnesota coach Flip Saunders, about as great of a pedigree you could ask for as a young coach.
Well, guys, you've heard me talk about the DNA when it relates to players. It's the same with coaches. I mean, Ryan has grown up seeing his dad coach at a high level, the late Flip Saunders, one of our favorites in the business. He spent his whole life around basketball, so he has a great way with players and a real good understanding of the game, too, a modern-day approach for a young coach.
Here's Okogie. He's been patient so far. Nothing on the scoreboard yet. Towns wide open. Good on the three-point shot.
You see, Towns doesn't dip much after the catch. I mean, he gets the ball right up to the set point and ready to deliver. Really sound fundamentals in that regard.
Paul looking for Adams. He gets it there.
And, guys, he's not an easy man to stop when he's got the rim in his sights.
Never has been, never will be. He is a determined finisher.
And, guys, I like the fact that he chose the one-hand tomahawk slam because you get a little higher when you go off one hand and one foot.
So the Timberwolves call their first timeout.
And you look at the way Steven Adams has developed his offense the last few years. It's been a huge boost for this team. He has always been a great defender, but now he is an important cog on this team in terms of scoring.
All against Russell. The pass to Towns. Beasley outside. That doesn't go on the chance to tie. And with Adams in his offense, you forget how young he is.
And big men, sometimes they just take a little longer to find their path in the NBA. And Adams has certainly found his. I remember him being in mostly to screen and rebound when he was a rookie, but look how far this game has come.
Well, I'll tell you what, he's going to buy himself a ticket to the bench if he keeps shooting it like that. He has been putrid here this quarter.
And that one's good. Russell.
Excelling in the pick and roll back at The Ohio State University. Russell bringing that skill along with him to the NBA. That skill travels well.
Now here's Paul. Last game he had 28 points. Tries again. And there's the basket. Whistle blows and a chance for a three-point play. Going to the line for one.
And of the last six baskets, five have come on the interior. This is just smash-mouth physical basketball, guys.
Here's what Minnesota's going with right now. James Johnson checked in for Hernan Gomez. Jake Lehman comes in for Josh Okogie. And Culver's subbed in for Beasley. And Adams, no good on that one. You know, Greg, for the Thunder fans, hard to see their star power dwindle, but they got a lot in return.
Yeah, but the Thunder were capped out. They hadn't made it past the first round in 3 years. And in exchange for Paul George, they got one of the richest trade packages in league history.
The Thunder with another miss. And so it's Russell with it. He'll bring it up for Minnesota. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line.
Yet another player from the 2019 draft class who wasn't a top high school recruit. Jarrett Culver, three-star guy, thin, unrefined. But in that sophomore year of college, boy, did he surprise some folks.
Shooting two.
And he makes the first. And Greg, when you talk about Culver, the one thing he did show in high school and again showed at Texas Tech, the ability to score.
Yeah, and he creates and makes shots against great defenders. Every team in the NBA is looking for that. His jumper, his handle, his ability to move without the ball, already NBA level stuff.
That one is no good.
And Culver's game just screams potential. Already a good scorer, rebounder, and passer. Now the next step, improving that outside shot.
And they've repeatedly probed inside in the first half, guys, and it's paid off.
Here's Reed. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two. It's going to be on Nerlens Noel. Minnesota shooting their fifth and six free throws of the game.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
He's off on the first. And Clark, when you look at how the game has changed, if you were entering the league today, how would you reshape your skill set?
Well, the biggest part would be expanding my shooting range. I was a good shooter at the time that I played, but would need to expand it and was just starting to stretch out my shooting to the three-point line. And then also defensively, be a little more committed to that end of the floor, really working to get better there. The ball handling, passing, scoring, rebounding, those were things that I did pretty well.
Oklahoma City trailing. Schroeder outside. That one's not going to go. And Minnesota will come the other way. Noel. He's guarded by Diallo. Passes it to Johnson. And that one is good. And the Timberwolves lead by three.
That's simply an outstanding play, working the size mismatch right at the rim.
Pass to Muscala. Here's Noel. No points in the game yet for him. Kicks it to Schroeder. and he lays it straight in.
Again and again, they're dissecting the defense and creating those high percentage looks from inside.
And even under pressure in close, I think they've still done a good job maintaining concentration and converting the opportunities.
Here's Reed after the made shot from Dennis Schroeder. Here's Reed. He's guarded by Schroeder. Reed gets the bucket.
The ball distribution was there. I mean, outstanding work all the way around.
Schroeder kicks to Muscala. Now here's Diallo. Not a lot of room. With the teardrop, he lays it in. Diallo's got his second bucket.
No defensive pressure at all. I mean, that's not going to get it done against him.
Culver passes to Reed. Noel. He's guarded by Diallo. And stolen by Noel. Now here's Diallo. He's guarded close. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. Greg, last season, Dennis Schroeder transitioning to more of a six-man role with the Thunder.
And for his first go at that role, I thought Schroeder looked really good. He's always been able to score and create, and coming off the bench might be the best spot for him.
And guys, what do you think about the offensive approach we've seen so far for the Timberwolves?
Well, I'll tell you what, they must have had a good shoot-around because they've been fantastic from long range so far, fellas.
And also another aspect of their game that's been super so far tonight is how they've been sharing the basketball.
That one drops. He ties it up.
And, you know, even though in today's game floor spacing is all the rage, the last 5 years the Wolves attempted the fewest threes in the league. And when they did shoot them, they didn't make very many of them.
That one misses, so he goes 1 for 2. And on top of their troubles from range, the Wolves have also had trouble on the defensive glass.
Yeah, and if you can't rebound and you're not shooting it well, you've got to figure out who you're going to be. Your identity is in question. That's what the Wolves are trying to figure out. Who are we? What do we do well? How do we win? How do we succeed? Get to the next level. They've got to answer that question.
Here's Schroeder following the score by Jarrett Culver.
Skying towards the hoop and decimating the defense with that ridiculous alley-oop dunk. Go ahead, Noel.
Here's Lehman. Still looking for his first bucket in this one. And it's a defensive 3-second violation. For Minnesota, they have made 4 free throws from the line and missed 2.
And it's been an average year, really, at the free throw line for this group, only around 75%.
And, Kevin, it's something they've been working very hard to correct and to change. I mean, they know how important it is to fix that inability at the free throw line.
And he shows the focus there, nails the technical. And for the Thunder, a lot of the assistant coaches leaving this past summer. Greg, how much of a concern is that for head coach Billy Donovan?
Possibly a sign that Donovan could be on the hot seat in OKC. I mean, 3 consecutive first-round exits. Donovan on the final year of his deal. The clock is definitely ticking.
Noel. It's rebounded by Oklahoma City.
Well, you have to like their work on the boards, Kevin, particularly here to start the game.
Yeah, I like the way they're setting the tone. Really playing with a lot of energy here at the start. He's certainly been cold this quarter, guys, but trying to shoot his way back into a groove.
Johnson dishes to Culver. 1:11 left in the first quarter. Beyond the arc. And it's Noel with the rebound. Oklahoma City's gone 0-2 from deep here. Schroeder passes to Ferguson. Over Johnson. Ferguson misses. Looking at the last game for the Timberwolves, it was a loss to Houston.
And that's his second foul already, and that's going to force him to tone down his aggression defensively.
There's 38 seconds left here in the first quarter. Noel, he's guarded by Diallo. Six on the shot clock. And the rejection by Noel.
And the shot blocking skills of Noel are a staple of his game, really one of the foundational pieces. He really takes a lot of pride in what he does on defense.
They are just killing him on the interior.
Yeah, you can't say that with enough emphasis. I mean, the defenders are just not being aggressive enough down low. You got to play with some physicality in the paint.
Johnson. That shot misses. One quarter in the books, and it's been a close one so far. Thunder lead by one. 2K Sports, back in a moment here in Oklahoma City. There's a great friendship between Melo, LeBron, Dwayne Wade, and Chris Paul, and Chris talked about where all that started.
It's been a sort of long relationship, you know, and obviously me, Bron, Melo, D. Wade have all really got really close. And that stems from the time with the Olympics, USA teams, and then just sharing a lot of the same likes and values and having kids and family and different things like that.
And you see that a lot nowadays. Star players developing friendships and GA spending time with each other off the floor.
Yeah, some people hate it because they want that bad blood you used to see, but no reason you have to hate someone to really compete against them.
And it's been a pretty even game here after one quarter of play. And for the Thunder guys, what stands out to you so far?
Well, in that first quarter, they were intent on just pounding the ball down low.
Yeah, and it's worked. They've got a clear edge and points in the paint. Now we'll see if they go with a more balanced attack or just keep on pounding it inside.
On the court for Minnesota, James Johnson is out there with Lehman. Then it's Culver, and it's Reed, and at the center, locking down the middle.
And the first few seasons in the NBA, not an easy time for Terrence Ferguson. Young wings have their ups and downs, but the franchise still very much believes in his talent.
That one is off. And with Ferguson, the fans can be hard on him. They're expecting more. But, Greg, it's going to take time for him.
You know, Ferguson has already made big strides with his defense. The shot and consistency will come, but the fans will have to be patient with him.
And the second free throw, good. Here's Culver. He had a 12-point outing in their last game against Houston. Pass to Reed. Now, here's Culver. He's guarded by Schroeder. The Thunder with the lead. Diallo the pass to Noel. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. Clark, I have sat next to you doing these games for years. What's prevented you from taking a coaching position at some level? Because I hear you talk, I'm thinking you'd be a perfect coach.
Well, a couple of things. One, coaching never lets up. It's always on you. And I've come to enjoy the fact that I can be fully immersed as a broadcaster and work with great guys like you and others, and then have a period of time where I don't have to be immersed in basketball. And I've enjoyed that. And I also haven't trained or prepared to be a coach because it is demanding in terms of the hours that you have to put in. And I've got a little more job security, I think, in the role that I serve as an analyst as opposed to what might happen if I did try to be a coach.
You've got all the security in the world, believe me. All free throws good from Noel.
And you think about the two best talents in Wolves history, KG, obviously, and probably Big Cat.
I would not disagree. I mean, KG is a Hall of Famer. The Cat, Karl-Anthony Towns, has been terrific early in his career. The rebounding and scoring, the versatility at that size between those two guys. Right. Could have possibly been like the Admiral and Tim Duncan.
Oh, what a dunk!
He's going to put that one in his scrapbook. Insane dunk.
And now they're starting to rub it in. Build up a lead, and here we go, baby. It is showtime.
And why not? A little salt in the wound. The more plays they make like that, the more they'll have these guys reeling and on the ropes.
The Thunder leading by 6. Here's Ferguson, and he banks in the layup. Ferguson's got 5 points in the quarter.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
And when you make 5 in a row in close like that, it also takes pressure off your perimeter guys, too.
And there's the pass to Reed. Pass to Culver. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. It's on Dennis Schroeder.
And what makes Culver difficult to defend, it starts with the footwork and then the change of pace, and you give him that ability to just rise up and shoot over you.
This is his second trip to the free throw line.
Not the best statistic for him in terms of his performance at the line. Very low numbers.
Guys, I think free throw shooting, and Steve, you can speak to this, is all about rhythm and confidence, and he hasn't been able to establish any rhythm there this season.
No good on that one.
And one thing the Wolves have done well over the past few seasons, taking care of the ball.
Yeah, you know, they squeeze it well. Low turnovers can be a double-edged sword, though. If you don't make many mistakes, maybe you're not being aggressive enough.
That's off as well, so he misses both. And so it's Gallinari with it. He'll bring it up for Oklahoma City. They haven't allowed any points in the second quarter. And it's good, 2 points.
They're getting on a roll inside. Their last 3 field goals have come from the paint.
And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, one of the things that teams are more aware of in the age of analytics is the importance of sleep. Those teams are making adjustments. Morning shoot-arounds have been moved in some cases to the afternoon or eliminated altogether. There are many fewer teams that are taking red-eye flights across country. And some teams even give players orange-tinted glasses to encourage them to sleep. There's a lot of work to be done in this field, but the direction is clear.
Continuing to evolve. All right, David, thank you. The Timberwolves again can't hit. Pass to Gilgeous Alexander and stolen by Russell. Out of bounds, Oklahoma City takes possession. And a quick look at how the Oklahoma City Thunder's schedule is shaping up. On Sunday, they'll take on John Wall and the Washington Wizards. Then on Tuesday, they'll be taking on Jonas Valanciunas and the Memphis Grizzlies.
You know, most teams might get worried at a long road schedule like this one, but they've been so good away from home. I think they might be looking forward to it. You have to respect what this team can do when they're in your building.
And the Timberwolves call time. Tough loss coming against the Rockets in the last game they played.
Well, I felt like they were never on the same page defensively in that one. Gave up way too many easy shots.
And, you know, that's all about effort, and I'm sure their coach let them have it for the lack thereof.
And checking out some stats for D'Angelo Russell. Unbelievable play for him over the last month. He's putting up about 21 points per, 6 assists, and 5 rebounds. And his playmaking really stands out, making his teammates better offensively with his terrific passing.
Yeah, he's outstanding at controlling the tempo. I mean, keeps the ball moving and, of course, finds the open man.
Towns and the dunk by Towns.
And powering it home, he ends a 12-0 run by Oklahoma City.
Paul against Russell. Paul, right side. Can't hit the step-back jump shot.
Well, I don't think he's performing up to his own expectations, but they still find themselves out in front.
Now here's Beasley. Tight defense on him. Clock at 4. Outside Russell. Front pass the arc. Gallinari with the rebound.
Just enough coverage to bother that 3-point attempt.
The dish to Paul. floater, and the rejection by Towns. Here's Okogie. And a miss there with a chance to cut the lead to single digits. The Thunder leading by 11. Molinari finds Paul. Paul can't get that one to fall.
Nothing seems to be going down for him today.
Here's Okogie. He's just scored his first basket with that shot, making him 1-for-4. And it's Oklahoma City's ball. They're on a 12-4 run. Here's Gilgeous-Alexander. And the rejection by Towns. Beasley, the pass to Russell. It's good. With that basket, he's now 5-for-9.
And, you know, once Russell catches fire now, let him eat. I mean, he's got the ability to take over games with his scoring.
Here's Paul. He gets it to go from 18 feet away. Paul's got 7 points in the game. Timberwolves trail by 9. Russell high post. He's got 12. Here's Towns. And Adams sends it back. To the wing right side. Here's Dort. Back to Gilgeous-Alexander. Pass to Gallinari. Second chance effort, and the layup is up and in. 8 points for him.
Second chance points always hurt. Just not enough effort to block out.
Hey, guys standing around spectating. I mean, you got to get in there and get tough.
Russell from long range. Minnesota working with a new shot clock. And Adams sends it back. And that's out of bounds. Minnesota will retain possession. So it's the Timberwolves now. 11-point game. Shot clock at 6. Goes back up. Buries the jump shot. Okogie's got 4 points now in the quarter. And it's Paul with the ball for the Thunder. 13 points was their biggest lead in the game. Down low, here's Gallinari. It's rebounded by Towns. Towns has got rebound number 10 tonight with that last one. Here's Okogie. He's averaging just around 8.5 points a game. Paul with the ball. Beasley covering. And the pass to Adams. Here's Gilgeous-Alexander. Shoots over Towns. Gilgeous-Alexander can't get it to go.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Passes to Okogie. And there's the foul. It's on Steven Adams. That's his first foul. Diallo, he's checked in for the Thunder.
Now in the lineup for your Thunder. Hamidou Diallo.
So it's the Timberwolves now. They trail by 9 points. And Adams sends it back. And there's Gallinari on the assist by Paul. Gallinari's got 10 points in the game.
What a sweet assist by CP3.
Pass to Towns. Here's Okogie. Adams defending. Here's Okogie. Buries it down low. Okogie's got 6 in the quarter.
And I like the fact that he really was unfazed by that scoreless first quarter. And now you can see him getting into a rhythm.
Paul outside. His three-pointer is off the mark. Timberwolves trail by 9. Well, we're now on the back end of what has been, Greg, an incredible career for Chris Paul. He's no longer the undisputed best point guard in the game, but still a top talent.
And Chris Paul might not be the best point guard, but any team would be happy to have him. His efficiency and playmaking aren't going away anytime soon. And even though he's never been an overly athletic player, that aspect of his game still is strong as ever.
Outside, Russell. Just five on the clock. Back to Beasley. Fires the three. Headshot off. So the Thunder will take it the other way. Here's Paul. Yep, that one goes in there. Paul's got the lead up to 13 now for the Thunder.
You know, it's really quite remarkable how well Paul operates on the inside. I mean, he's not just a perimeter player. I mean, if he can get in tight, he's going to do it.
From the top of the key, and Towns gets it to go. 11 points in the game.
Just such a well-rounded offensive player. He's got a little bit of everything.
Timeout is called. First of the game for the Thunder. A lot of different ways, Clark, to construct a roster. What would be your preference as a general manager? Any direction you might want to go?
Well, obviously, if you have an opportunity to get an outstanding franchise-type point guard or versatile wing player in today's game, I think those are the pieces that you really need to start with.
Because there's so much spacing and so much switching on defense.
Exactly, and I failed to mention a two-way player at that wing spot who can defend multiple positions but also has a pretty strong offensive skill set.
Noel's checked in for Adams. Muscala comes in for Gallinari. Ferguson's checked in for Shea Gilgeous-Alexander. And Dennis Schroeder subbed in for Paul. Diallo kicks to Noel. Schroeder outside. Noel dishes to Schroeder. Banked in off the glass. Schroeder's got seven.
Well, there's nothing like being unselfish as a player, and Noel was outstanding in that regard, reading the entire floor and finding his guys for high-percentage shots.
Noel against Towns. Noel, he's guarded by Diallo, and they're able to recover. And there's the shot clock violation. Couldn't get the shot off in time. Culver's checked in for Minnesota.
Jared Culver.
Oklahoma City leading by 13. Pass to Muscala. Now Noel. Looking at his point production, he averages almost 8 points a game. From 17 feet out, and it's Schroeder missing. Schroeder's gotten three of his eight shots to go, around 37%. Johnson goes in. It's rebounded by Oklahoma City.
And we haven't seen them get to the line as much here in the second quarter. They might be settling a tad too much offensively.
I think you're right. I mean, an up fake here or there, getting the ball inside. That's how you create high percentage offense. That's his second foul of the first half. Not a big deal yet, but something to keep an eye on.
On defense, the Timberwolves. It's a 13-point game. Six to shoot. Now the pass to Schroeder. Lets the three fly. Buries the long-range jumper. 10 points for him.
He's starting to find himself out there now. You know, he's taking much better shots here in the second quarter.
They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions. Right now, they need a basket.
Reed the pass to Lehman. Here's Culver. Johnson outside. And oh, he blocked it and deflects off the backboard. That's a two from Ferguson. The rebound by Johnson. Timberwolves trail by 16.
Oklahoma City foul.
Minnesota with the ball. Here's Culver. Lays it up and banks it in. Culver's got his second basket of the night.
And Kevin, they started the game shooting it so well. I'm surprised they haven't continued. They've got to get back to their strength.
Yeah, I mean, test the hot hand. You're exactly right. I say let those triples fly.
To the right side. Here's Diallo. A three-pointer off the mark. And so it's Oklahoma City sitting with a comfortable lead up by 14. Their defense has been terrific in this game. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Kevin, thanks. Billy, balanced scoring for your team. How pleased are you with the way they're keeping everybody involved offensively?
Well, those guys, I think, have done a really good job of moving the ball and sharing the ball, and they're finding open men and they're willing passers, and I think because of that, they've been efficient offensively.
Open shots tend to be made. Thanks, Coach. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, Dave, thank you. And time now for the halftime break with the third quarter soon to follow right here on 2K Sports.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Welcome back to 2K Sports, everybody. Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith. Let's talk about that first half. A competitive matchup for Oklahoma City in the first quarter. They did jump out to a lead in the opening period, but 4 points was the biggest it got. They just exploded in the second quarter, grabbing the momentum and running with it. Basket after basket, and they played stingy defense. Now they've got a halftime lead that's going to be very difficult to erase. Kenny, let's get your take on Oklahoma City.
What a brilliant, unselfish half of basketball they just played. Their ball movement was absolutely impeccable. All in all, just beautiful basketball to watch.
How about you, Shaq? What'd you think about Minnesota?
Well, you live by the three and you die by the three. And today, they're dying. And as cold as they've been behind the arc, they keep firing from deep. What are you doing? I know they got a lot of ground to make up, but they can't continue with this game plan. Not working.
And that's a wrap for our halftime show. The third quarter just about to get started.
And with a big gap on the scoreboard, the second half begins with very different goals for these teams. One side trying to mount a comeback, one side trying to protect their lead. You look at D'Angelo Russell. What a contribution.
No problems fighting his way to the rim in this one. A lot of points in close.
Yeah, you know what, guys? They gave him too many free runs to the hoop in the first half. I think they've got to be a lot tougher on him. Body him up. Be physical with him.
Gallinari and Adams, the combo out front. Hall out there with Gilgeous Alexander. And it's Dort in at the three. That's Billy Donovan's five as we get going here in the second half. And it's out of bounds. The Thunder able to retain possession.
All right, a chance to see some stats for Gilgeous Alexander. The past month has been surreal. Putting up about 18 points per, 6 rebounds, and 4 assists. Well, you know that he can put points up in a hurry, and he leads this team in scoring.
Yeah, you know, I think he's got a great sense of how to keep their offense going and being productive. If somebody else is having an off night, then he kind of steps in and fills the gap.
And it's Paul missing. Timberwolves trail by 12. Here's Okogie. Outside, Towns. He gets it to fall. That makes it just a single-digit lead. Towns has got 5 points in the quarter. Passes it to Dort. Here in this third quarter, just over a minute play. Pass to Gallinari. Just 5 to shoot. 11 feet away. Rebound by Okogie. Okogie's got his 4th rebound in this one. And the call on the shot sends him to the line.
Well, you got to give a lot of credit to Josh Okogie. I mean, he was the 20th pick in the 2018 draft and really well ahead of the curve as a rookie and even saw starter minutes later on in the season. Well, that's a great get for them.
The first one falls, and meteoric rises not uncommon for Okogie.
Yeah, and Okogie's done a really nice job kind of turning the impression of him around because he wasn't highly touted in college, but I tell you what, he's proven to be an impact player because of how he can defend and shoot.
And so he makes both from the line. And Gilgeous Alexander's got the ball here for the Thunder. Right wing. Here's Paul. No good on the shot, a bit long that time.
They have yet to hit a shot. A real slow start here in the second half.
Beasley, the pass to Russell. Pass to Okogie. Lock at six. Here's Towns. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up. Steven Adams picks one up.
A guy with the size and skill of Towns, Kevin, really hard to stop without fouling.
And the last 2 years, Karl Anthony Towns getting a rap as a bad defender. Clark, do you think that's fair to say?
You know what, Kevin? I don't think it's as fair as it once was. He's not nearly the defensive liability he used to be. He's better defensively one-on-one, and I think he's improved in his ability to switch and rotate on smaller players.
And the first one at the line is good.
And you look at how Towns is so effective on offense, and it's because he really has the entire package for a big man. Back to the basket, facing up, playing outside or in, off the bounce or on the catch. This guy can do it all.
And Towns drops them both. And Greg, as you said, it's the skill level of Towns at his young age that is so incredible.
Very capable three-ball shooter, but he likes backing you down on the block as well. You step back and look at what he can do for a team, and there aren't really any holes in his game.
Finally, they get one to drop. That's one of their first four here in the third.
Beasley dishes to Towns. He kicks it to Russell. Let's go. Beasley with a clean look. Good, and it's Russell picking up the assist.
Yeah, this looks like a pregame shoot-around with all the threes they're allowing.
Paul passes to Adams. Now, here's Gilgeous Alexander. Back to Gallinari. Fires from 18. That's the sixth make from the field. He's taken nine shots and missed but three.
In the mid-range, rarely the hallmark of efficiency in today's NBA, but it is on point tonight.
It sure is, Greg. It might be the strongest aspect of their offense here.
All right, let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, D'Angelo Russell was traded from the Lakers and, in his words, was kicked on the way out. He's become an all-star in Brooklyn. Russell said, "It's a heck of an accomplishment. That respect from your peers, your coaches, other teams, it's a great feeling." And Kevin, given how it started for him in L.A., many remain shocked by Russell's rapid ascent.
Coming into his own, you're right, David. Thank you. Russell against Paul. Russell, no luck.
And that is a textbook example of how to defend your rim.
And you know, guys, I love his fight and grit on the interior. I mean, he never lets a shot go uncontested.
And Adams kicks to Paul. The pass to Dort. There's Gallinari with the three. He can't get that one to fall. And Minnesota now the other way. Pass to Okogie. Uncovered. They get the rebound. Hernan Gomez. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws.
Yeah, easy call.
Yeah, you can hear the smack all the way over here where we are.
And let's get your take, guys, on the scoring breakdown for Oklahoma City.
And they haven't been pushed around in the paint at all in this game. They have been the aggressors.
They've also jumped on any opportunity they've had to attack the basket tonight. I mean, excellent penetration.
First one falls for.
Wow, they've made every free throw here in the second half.
And that efficiency, Greg, as you know, so critical when you're looking to overcome a deficit. You've got to be close to perfect and can't waste scoring opportunities.
He's perfect from the line this time. Oklahoma City leading by six. And here is Paul. He's got 11. Inside, Gallinari with it. Now guarded by Towns.
Well, you see the great reach as well as the relentless pursuit shown by Towns. He's simply saying, not here, not now, not in my house.
Paul, no one around him. Misses the three.
Well, he had one three-pointer in the first half, but so far in the second, he's come up with goose eggs.
Here's a Kobe. 8 points for him. Five on the clock. Tries a three. It's rebounded by Oklahoma City. Adams has got rebound number 8 here tonight in the game.
He's lost it in this quarter, no doubt about it. Nothing seems to be going for him.
And now let's see who the NBA's hottest shooters have been in the second half of the season. Fifth is Steven Adams.
His touch around the bucket has been outstanding. I mean, he has missed very few of the good looks he's gotten.
Shooting two.
That's good from Gilgeous Alexander. That's also good. So he hits both free throws. Here's Beasley. And they get some nice contributions from him on a nightly basis as he averages over 11 points a game. Outside, Towns. Beasley outside. Goes up to the stripe. Ferguson with the rebound. Count the basket. 20 points for Karl Anthony Towns.
Good luck trying to keep Cat off the glass. Karl Anthony Towns loves mixing it up down low and getting after those second chances.
Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City.
OKC, make some noise for your Thunder Girl.
Shooters check in for Gilgeous Alexander. Timberwolves also changing it up. Jake Lehman comes in for Josh Okogie. And Culver's subbed in for Beasley. Culver with the steal. Here's Russell. Finished off the break. Russell's got 14 points.
Hey, I can't overstate it. I mean, as a defense in transition, you have to locate Russell before he finds the bottom of the net. You've got to get to him quickly.
Pass to Paul. And here's Gallinari. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
I mean, even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
No question about it, Greg. I mean, a ton of contact and a good call by the official.
The Thunder have shot the ball pretty well from the line, going 8 of 11.
And how about as a group, 80% on the season, one of their
shooting
best
two.
Attributes.
That's been one of the strongest aspects of this team this season. I mean, there have been very few off nights for them at the free throw line.
That free throw good from Gallinari, and the Thunder making a switch here. Muscala's checked in. Gallinari hits them both.
And among NBA bigs, he is known for his ability to deliver at the free throw line.
Russell looking around. And with that, the Thunder lead is cut down to just 4 points in the bucket from Reed.
And guys, the D has to show a little more fight on the interior than they did on that trip.
Shooter passes to Gallinari. Well, trying to break loose, and it's Gallinari missing.
It's really a tale of two quarters. Shot it so well in the last, but this one can't get anything to fall.
Looking at the Timberwolves, let's see where they rank in the NBA statistics right now.
And you look at all those steals. I mean, they play an in-your-face aggressive style of defense. Even advancing the ball can prove to be a challenge, and they tend to feed off of that.
And he knocks down the first one. Diallo, he's checked in for Oklahoma City. And so he hits both. And so it's Schroeder with the ball. He'll bring it up for the Thunder. At one point, they led by 16. Pass to Noel. That's tipped. Six to shoot. Schroeder outside. Here's Diallo. The Thunder with another miss.
And they haven't been able to turn it into a big lead, but their rebounding advantage is starting to add up.
Yeah, still close, but with their tough play on the boards, we're certainly seeing the effort.
Here's Ferguson. He has five. Out to the right wing. That one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and two shots coming up.
And let's take a moment here to see some of the numbers for Karl-Anthony Towns. Putting up 26 points per, 11 rebounds and 4 assists. And you talk about guys who just have a nose for putting up points. He is one of them.
Yeah, he sure is. And he rarely has back-to-back bad games. If he has an off night, he usually follows that up with a big night.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
The first free throw is good. And he can't hit the second.
Not an A-plus trip to the line, but he did get them the lead.
Russell from long range. The Thunder pull it in.
And the great shooters know when they've got enough opening to go for the three. I didn't think it was a bad choice on that possession.
Over to the wing. There's Noel. The Thunder with another miss. Minnesota's gone into the three-point range four times since halftime and buried two of them.
You know, early in his career, there were questions surrounding D'Angelo Russell's maturity, and understandably so. That's the case with most young players. But of late, in his case, his improvement as a player and his growth as a person is impressive.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Well, I agree with you. Four of their last five baskets have been exactly of that variety.
Goes up, and the slam dunk by Russell.
Boy, improving as a two-way threat. It's big when Russell is making an impact on both offense and defense.
And beginning his career with the Lakers, coaches wanted Russell to take a more serious approach.
Yeah, you know what? I think his last year there, losing the trust of his teammates, probably woke him up a bit. Sometimes you got to go through the adversity to recognize what you need to change. It's not enough to just put up numbers. You've got to be a professional in how you go about your business. And plenty to like about where D'Angelo Russell is and where he's headed.
The pass to Reed. Here's Culver. That one good for two. Culver's got the lead back up to three now for the Timberwolves.
And defensively, these guys are looking for answers. Since halftime, they've seemed disjointed and out of sync. They have got to get back that rhythm defensively.
Passes it to Ferguson. Launches a three. Sinks the three-pointer. Ferguson's got the game tied up here for the Thunder.
And no matter who it is, that kind of D isn't going to get it done.
Ball's knocked loose. Now, here's Culver. He's guarded by Schroeder. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line. And let's get a look at a group of point guards who have been rolling in the second half of the season with some very important and impressive point totals. Fifth is D'Angelo Russell.
Well, this is a collection of maybe the most well-rounded players in our league. I mean, to see those kinds of scoring numbers from the point guard position is crazy.
Yeah, and that's the age we're living in right now. I mean, it's not uncommon to see a point guard lead his team in scoring, which used to be almost unheard of. And these guys here are all capable of carrying the scoring load for their team on any given night.
And he makes the first. Gallinari, he's checked in for Diallo. And he makes both free throws.
And if they continue, Kevin, their outstanding free throw shooting, that'll help them seal the deal.
Yeah, they've not missed a single foul shot this half. That's taking care of business, fellas.
And it's Schroeder missing. Minnesota in the lead. 1:19 left in the third quarter. Here's Culver. Nails the wide-open jump shot. Culver's got six in the quarter.
Just make sure you keep getting him touches. I mean, you love what he's doing at the offensive end. Don't go away from it.
Oklahoma City moving it around. Here's Gallinari. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line. That's on D'Angelo Russell. Now let's take a moment to get your guys' take on the scoring so far for the Timberwolves.
They keep piling up the assists, and they haven't cooled off at all.
They've repeatedly gotten out on the break tonight as well and scored a lot of baskets in transition.
Shoot two.
First one falls for.
Yeah, and the work they've done at the line has been impressive here in the second half.
And the Timberwolves making a change here. Beasley's checked in. So he picks up just one from the line that time.
And just a better job of getting to the line here in the second half. Didn't get there once in the first.
Exactly what you want from your point guard. Nice dime to the open teammate by Russell.
Thunder trailing by five. There's 45 seconds left to play here in the third. Ferguson kicks it over to Schroeder. Minnesota with the rebound. Russell's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. Beasley, the pass to Russell. Here's Reed. He's guarded by Schroeder. From 17 feet out, misses off the right iron.
And he rushed that one, no doubt about it. The D out of position, you could see the frustration on his face.
Back to Gallinari. The shot's good on the assist by Schroeder. 17 points for Gallinari.
Wow, fired that bounce pass in there. Beautiful.
It's been all about Karl Anthony Towns for the Minnesota Timberwolves. His production has been flowing as he's tallied 20 points and looks to be planning for more. And we'll be right back after this. And now we have a moment to reveal our State Farm assist of the game.
Yeah, a terrific, unselfish play right here. Set up his teammate, and how about the setup this was?
Yeah, and as a two guard, he's typically not a reluctant shooter, so it was really nice to see him orchestrating for a teammate instead.
And I know I speak for all of us when I say I can't wait to see what kind of finish awaits us here in the fourth quarter. A moment now to reset the lineups, brought to us by Gatorade, all fueled up here for the fourth quarter. On the court for Minnesota, Beasley is out there with D'Angelo Russell. Then it's Johnson, and it's Reed in at center. Gallinari outside. Russell against Schroeder. Just four to shoot. To tie it up. They grab their own miss. They blow the whistle just as he gets it off. That's 2 points with a chance for another one at the stripe.
The rebounding instincts of Noel are sublime, special. He just sees shot trajectories so well. I mean, he anticipates and then positions himself accordingly.
And it's tied up with that one.
The former Kentucky Wildcat Noel is a phenomenal defensive player. He's really starting to find himself on offense as well.
Outside Russell. Floats one, and the rejection by Noel. Here's Gallinari to take the lead. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
That free throw, no good.
And they're having a lot of trouble at the line today. And unfortunately, it's the kind of day we've seen this team have a lot.
And the Timberwolves making a change here. Okogie's checked in. And that drops, so they now lead by one. And so it's Russell with it. He brings it up for Minnesota. Johnson outside. Nice ball movement by Minnesota. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
Wow, wow, he got whacked on that one. Shouldn't be much debate there.
Blatant contact. Straightforward call. Simple.
Two shots.
And he knocks down the first one. And Oklahoma City making a change here. Paul's checked in. Both shots good from the stripe. A few possessions into the fourth quarter, just over a minute played. Pass to Dort. Kicks it to Gallinari. That shot off. Good D by Johnson. Gallinari with the steal. 11 feet away. And stolen by Russell. Now here's Beasley. Gilgeous Alexander cover. Beasley outside. Shot clock at 5. The shot from the low post is good.
I like the play call. Very solid, making perfect use of the pick to get a great look.
Gilgeous Alexander surveying the D. With a floater. Excellent D there by Johnson. Timberwolves leading by 3. Pass to Russell. Johnson kicks to Beasley. To the middle. And Adams sends it back. And he gets it back. For Oklahoma City, they've gone 1-5 from the field here in the fourth. A lot of misses, just the one make. Here's Dort. Hermann Gomez grabs the miss.
Well, what appeared to be an easy 2 points just never materialized.
Okogie, the pass to Johnson. Russell against Adams. Russell kicks to Hernan Gomez. There's the pass to Johnson. Russell from long range. Nailed from three-point land. Russell's got 19 points.
Watch out. Now that he's got his first three of the half, there will be more in store.
Here's Paul. And that one hits back iron. Timberwolves have gone 2-for-5 on field goal attempts in the fourth quarter. Here's Juan Gomez. And that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. That one on Gallinari.
Yeah, how about the body control on that one? Narrowly misses getting the deuce.
Boy, he had a nice look at it after drawing the foul. Boy, it would have been nice to get an and one there.
And that one misses. Carl Anthony Towns checked in for James Johnson. He hits the second from the line. Under trailing by 7. Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City. And at this point of the game, getting a break here. Important for the teams to regroup. And for the players, this is where you have a chance to get rehydrated with Gatorade. Get ready to play strong to finish off the game. And we've got an update here, so let's catch up with David Aldridge.
Well, over that last break, Kevin, I got a chance to listen to what Billy Donovan said to his team. He said, look, you guys are playing physical, and I like that. But it has to be under control. We've committed way too many fouls. We've allowed way too many foul shots. Kevin?
Thanks, David.
And then they continue to control the glass.
Guys, I think they've simply been the more physical team, and that's why they're ahead.
Beasley outside. Towns, no luck. And Gilgeous Alexander's got the ball here for the Oklahoma City Thunder. They trail by 7. From deep, Gallinari. And a great assist by Gilgeous Alexander as that one goes in. Gilgeous Alexander's got 4 assists in the game. Outside, Russell. Passes it to Hernan Gomez. Shot clock at 6. For 3, Akogi. It's hauled in by Adams. Adams has got double-digit rebounds now in the game. Here's Dort. It's hauled in by Karl-Anthony Towns. Towns has got rebound number 19 now. Incredible board work. Beasley kicks to Russell. At the top of the key, Towns. The Timberwolves working the ball around now. Poked away. It's stolen by Adams. Here's Dort. Second chance shot. And plenty of contact on the shot. So, 2 free throws coming up. And a foul called on Minnesota.
Steven Adams. Shooting.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
First free throw is good. He doesn't get the second one. Timberwolves leading by 3. Pass to Akogi. Towns against Adams for 3. Hernan Gomez, no good. Oklahoma City has gone 1-of-3 from outside the arc since we've reached the fourth quarter. And it's Gallinari missing. The Timberwolves have gone just 2-of-8 in this fourth quarter. The final quarter not treating them well so far. Now here's Beasley. Gilgeous Alexander covering. Akogi, the pass to Hernan Gomez. Paul against Russell. Over Paul. Another miss by Minnesota. Under trailing by 3. Pass to Dort. From 16, rebounded by the Timberwolves. Towns is. Here's Akogi. He kicks it to Beasley. And there's the pass to Akogi. Passes to Towns. Outside, Russell. Their offense, stone cold. Another miss there. They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
Dort passes to Paul. Over Russell. And with that shot, the Minnesota lead is cut down to just 1 on the bucket from Paul.
You know, he does it easily, and it's really smooth the way he scores. Paul's form and release on the shot, really about as good as it gets.
Beasley kicks to Towns. It's hauled in by Adams.
And he did everything he could to make that shot as difficult as possible.
And you know what, guys? That will pump him up because he takes a ton of pride in what he does on defense.
And he gets contact and the whistle on the shot. 2 shots coming up.
Shooting 2.
ties it up, and this next one could give them the lead. And that one falls, and that puts them up by 1 point. Minnesota's gone into a funk from downtown in the fourth. Only one of their 5 three-pointers has found the bottom of the bucket. Pass to Hernan Gomez. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Okogie. The Timberwolves again can't hit.
And there have been some terrible shot choices here, Kev. That's not a good look at all. And those are the types of shots down the stretch that win you ball game.
Minnesota calls timeout.
Trying to find some answers offensively.
Yeah, and you know, that's going to be the focus of this timeout. They need to come up with a spark to get the offense going.
Danilo Gallinari.
And he's put on a terrific show of skill in the paint. A combination of moves, footwork, and that soft touch down low. It's all added up to one dominant performance for the big fella.
Johnson, he's checked in for the Timberwolves. Here's Russell. Pass to Okogie. Trying to get something going. The shot, no good. So the Thunder will take it the other way. Here's Dort. Hall for 3. Beasley with the rebound. Timberwolves trail by 4. Johnson, the pass to Okogie. And they call the foul, so a chance at the line for one more coming up.
And how about the grit and determination in the post? I mean, essential qualities to have late in a close game.
One shot. One shot.
And so it's Paul bringing it up for Oklahoma City. They lead by 1. Steps back and shoots. Rebounded by the Timberwolves.
Boy, the defense got lucky there with him missing. But they don't want to chance that again.
Here's Russell. Bucket is good. Russell's got 9 points now in just the second half.
And now just having some fun. Russell, you know he likes the big moment. Great confidence and great results.
Gallinari outside. Adams trying to free himself up. And 2 free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the contact. That one's on Johnson.
Shooting 2.
The first one falls. Gallinari hits them both. Timberwolves trail. Beasley outside. The kick out to Towns. Good, and it's Russell picking up the assist. Russell's got 6 assists here tonight.
That gives him his second 3 of the half with 3 total for the game.
Paul with the ball. He's picked up by Russell. Adams, the pass to Gilgeous Alexander. Here's Dort. The Thunder with another miss.
And he has definitely been struggling in this quarter.
You know, guys, it seems to me as though he's over-anxious. He seems to be pressing, trying too hard, moving too fast. Just needs to calm himself down and wait for good shots.
It's Russell with the drive. And the slam dunk by Russell.
Big guard, nice handle. D'Angelo can take you a number of ways off the drive.
Gilgeous Alexander with it. Softly drops in the fourth.
Oh, perfect timing there to knock down the teardrop.
And the Timberwolves call timeout. They're in front by 2. There's 1:54 left in the fourth quarter of this one. There's 1:54 left to play here in the fourth. Paul with the steal. 2-on-1 as they jump out on the break. A nice shot by Gallinari.
And that's right in his wheelhouse, looking to make an impact when it counts.
You know, they want the ball in his hands here because they trust him to hit all the big shots.
Outside, Russell. The pass to Towns. Shoots over Adams. And he overshot that one, missing. Oklahoma City's got a disappointing 2-6 on 3-point attempts here in the fourth. Gallinari finds Gilgeous Alexander. Mulligan's Russell looking to get back on track here, and it's Paul getting it to go. Paul's got 4 points this quarter.
Mr. Clutch coming through. Chris Paul in a situation where there are must-have points. He cashes in.
Easily outside. Six on the shot clock. A 3. Knocks down the 3.
And you can't get a bigger bucket than that.
Well, that was 1-2. He wanted the ball. Nobody else was taking that shot.
Time called here. The Thunder decide to talk it over. They're behind by 1. There's 47 seconds left in the game. Against Russell. Gallinari trying to get open. Here's Adams. Pass to Paul. And another shot. Money!
Well, Paul's got him dropping right now for sure.
30 seconds left in the fourth quarter. And the Timberwolves call timeout. They're trailing by 1. 26 seconds left here in the fourth quarter.
Here's your Thunder Girls. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up.
Here's Russell. 6 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. And now they foul and stop the clock.
Yeah, that's right. No other option but to foul and hope for some misses.
Yeah, they have to extend the game. I mean, plain and simple. Use every second you can on the clock here.
Shooting two.
He drops the first one, and that will put them up by two.
Both prolific and efficient. Ultra competitive as well. Paul is a double-double threat who shoots a very high percentage from the floor and line.
And he hits both free throws here. So now it's a three-point game.
Absolutely massive free throws. That'll force them into a three-point attempt.
To the inside, shoots. Pass to Beasley from deep. The three won't fall.
And that was a little bit of a range check for him.
You know, guys, I think he's got confidence to shoot it from anywhere, but he could have gotten a better one than that.
Shooting two.
Gets the first, and that gives them a four-point cushion. And so he drops them both. It's a five-point game.
Good composure from the line there. Those shots sealed.
So it's Oklahoma City picking up the win. It was a fantastic ball game, and they did a great job making sure it didn't get away from them late.
Yeah, I mean, they faced some challenges, but really held firm when they needed to. On both ends, just effective in terms of coming away with this win.
And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much. Danilo, transition, big for your team. I assume that was a big focus tonight.
Yes, we want to run, and that's what we have to do every time. So that's what we did, and we played a great game.
Gallo, thanks very much. Congrats again. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, great job. Thanks so much. Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. For Greg Anthony, Clark Kellogg, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. So long, everyone.